Hello everyone, Uday Shankar here. Welcome to my channel, Knowledge Shared to Delete Ignorance. This channel is created to share the knowledge of known ideas to the society. And today in this channel, we will be discussing about wind energy conversions. Kindly subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon for future notifications. Also, if you find that this video will be useful to someone, please share this video to your friends. And now, let's go into today's topic. Wind energy conversion systems. First of all, I will give you an overview of the presentation, then we will discuss the topics in detail. So, in this presentation, we will be discussing the following topics. That is, first we will be discussing about the lift and drag type machines in wind energy conversion systems. And then we will be moving to HAWT versus VAWT. Is the hot topic nowadays, that is horizontal axis wind turbine versus vertical axis wind turbine. What we will be second topic, and then we will be moving towards what are the different speed control strategies for wind turbine. Then afterwards we will be discussing about the characteristics of the wind turbine, that is power versus wind speed characteristics. Okay, that is power versus wind speed characteristics of the wind turbine, which is a very very important topic in the wind energy conversion system. So there are four different regions as you see from, that is low speed region, maximum power coefficient region, constant power region, whirling speed region. What are the importance of different regions and when these regions come into play, all those things. And finally, we will be closing this session by discussing a small intro regarding this stall regulation with pitch regulation in WCS, which is used for speed control and also to implement the MPPT, the wind energy conversion. So now let us go into the topics. So as I have said, first we will be discussing about, that is lift type machines in WCS. The wind turbines make use of either the lift force or the drag force to cause the motion, and accordingly they are classified as lift type machines and drag type machines. In case of lift type machines, the ratio of lift to drag forces may be as high as 30:1. But whereas for drag design, the wind literally pushes the blades out of the way. The drag devices are less efficient and turn slower than wind. They produce high torque and thus are suitable for pumping applications only. At high wind speeds, they will spill the wind instead of producing more energy. Thus, they do not benefit from high energy density that is available in the wind. In case of lift blade design, it employs the same principle that is used in aeroplanes, kites, and as well as birds to fly. The blade is essentially an airfoil or a wing. When air flows past the blade, that is when air is flowing towards the blade, a wind speed and pressure differential is created between the upper and lower blade surfaces. The pressure at lower blade surface is greater and thus it acts to lift the blade. When blades are attached to the central axis like wind turbine rotor, the lift is translated into rotational motion. Lift powered wind turbines have much higher rotational speeds than the drag type machines, and therefore they are well suited for electric power generation. Lift devices are more efficient and turn faster than wind. They are able to benefit from high power densities available in strong winds. The ratio of power extracted from the wind by lift device to that of drag device is usually greater, that is it will be in the order of 3:1 for the same area construction. Lift type rotors are often tapered or twisted to reduce the bending stress and to improve the stalling performance. And if you see the types and characteristics of various types of rotors, Each and every type of rotor will be having its own tip speed ratio. So as you all know that the tip speed ratio is the ratio which will be changing according to the wind speed. Okay, which will be changing according to the wind speed. So and by changing the turbine speed proportionately with respect to the wind speed, we can maintain the constant tip speed ratio. So each and every machine will be having a tip speed ratio at which the maximum power coefficient can be achieved. And so we since the wind speed is always changing, we want to vary the turbine speed proportionately in order to maintain the tip speed ratio at the CP max level. So there are many types of rotor available, and like for example sail wing rotor is available, multi blade rotor is available, and Dutch type rotor is available, Sevenius rotor is available, Darius rotor is available, Musgrove and Evans rotors are available. So each and every rotor blades are having its own tip speed ratio, and they are suitable. Some of the rotors are suitable for electric power generation, whereas some of the rotors are suitable for pumping applications. So the rotors which are having the tip speed ratio of very less tip speed ratio less than 5 are suitable only for the water pump applications, whereas the rotors which are having the tip speed ratios greater than 5 and up to 20, they will be more suitable for the electric power generation. So from this we can understand that the two blade, three blade and single blade designs are suitable for the power generation, whereas the Darius also is suitable for electric power generation, whereas the Musgrove and Evans rotor will be having the tip speed ratio of very less value of around 3 to 4, and they will be suitable only for the pumping applications. Similarly, the Sevenius rotor is also will be more suitable for the pumping application than the electric power generation, because its tip speed ratio is only 1. So it's all depends upon the solidity nature. The solidity nature is nothing but for example, if you take the solidity of the Sevenius rotor, is nothing but unity, whereas American multi-blade rotor, it is nothing but 0.7. but whereas in lifted devices the solidity will be very less, when less than 0.1. okay, so when the solidity is very less, it will be more suitable for the electric power generation, because the tip speed ratio will be quite high when compared to the other types of rotor. And since because of this, the airfoil blades are more suitable for the electric power generation. So that's why we maintain the solidity in the range of 0.1. So this is what is the drag type machine. So in case of drag type, this is the Sevenius rotor which has been shown here, in which the solidity is 1. Okay, so solidity is 1. And because of which this is not suitable for the electric power generation, whereas this is more suitable for the water pumping application. So it can also be used for electric power generation, but the problem is it is more suitable for water pumping applications than the electric power generation due to its low tip speed ratio because of its high solidity in nature. So the tip speed ratio of the Sevenius rotor is only in the order of 1. Okay, so that's why it is not electric power station. And many researchers are going on, because this Sevenius rotor is more suitable for low speed application. As you know that the cut-in speed of the the cut-in speed for electric power generation is in the order of 5 meter per second. So cutout speed is around 25 meter per second. Only above 5 meter per second the electric power generation starts. Okay, because less than five, the wind speed is less than 5 meter per second, then it will result in more losses than the generation, because of which overheating will occur and it will reduce the life of the machine. That's why the machine will not be allowed to generate the power when the wind speed is less than 5 meter per second in case of lift type of machine, like a single blade, two blade and three blade structures. Whereas the Sevenius rotor, which is having the solidity of unity, are more suitable for even very low wind speed applications. But the problem is since the tip speed ratio is only 1, the energy extraction from the wind is very less when compared to 3 blade and 2 blade structure. So many researches are also going on the Sevenius rotor. So now we will discuss about what is the difference between the horizontal axis wind turbine and vertical axis wind turbine. As you know that most of the wind turbines used and present are of the type that is horizontal axis turbine. Okay, horizontal axis turbine. So it is because the turbine is placed horizontally. Okay, the turbine is placed horizontally with respect to the ground. Okay, that's why it is called as horizontal axis. Okay, and it has been well researched, and also they have gone many field trials has also been done, and from which the horizontal axis wind turbine is a well established technology. It's a well established technology, and some of the advantages of VAWT. Okay, so for example, VAWT is also having some of an advantage, and now it is having gained some considerable interest in this type of VAWT. It is because the VAWT, that is vertical axis wind turbine, you can see that from the figure itself. You can see that in case of vertical axis wind turbine, it is perpendicular to the ground. Okay, the rotor is placed perpendicular with respect to ground, that is, it is placed vertically. Okay, the rotor axis is vertical with respect to ground, whereas here in this case, horizontal axis wind turbine, you can see that the rotor axis is horizontal with respect to ground. That's why it is called as a horizontal axis wind turbine, and this is called as the vertical axis wind turbine. And here there are many types of vertical axis wind turbine, but this is the most famous one, that is the DACE type, which I have taken and have shown. So here, that is the main advantages. Okay, so for example, as I have told, there are many advantages in VAWT. That is, VAWT is having the advantage, like the first one is it can accept the wind from any direction. So there is no need for any adjustment using the that is your yaw control or pitch control in order to orient the rotor, in order to orient the nacelle towards the wind direction, which is not needed in case of the VAWT. So that is one main advantage. Okay, and also the gearing and generators are located at the ground level. You can see that the gearing, all the gears and generator are located at the ground level, and because of which the maintenance is very, very easy. Okay, because it is located at the ground level, it is very easy to maintain. But whereas in case of VAWT, you can see that the generator and gearbox are maintained at the height of the hub. Okay, so because the generator and gearbox are placed in the nozzle, which is placed on top. Okay, so because of which, if there is any failure or if there is any maintenance requirement for this gearbox and generator, a maintenance person has to travel long, has to climb a very high height, and he has to be there for maintenance purpose. Whereas it is very easy for us to maintain in case of the horizontal, vertical axis wind turbine. Okay. So that is the main advantage. So which has caused our attraction towards this. And also it is very less costly when compared to HWT. But there are many disadvantages also in case of VAWT. That is, for example, it will be having some resonance problems in its structure, and because of which it will also produce only less amount of output power. This is one major drawback. And also, the rotational torque from the wind is varying periodically, and thus unwanted power the power fluctuations will be very high in this case. That is the main drawback again in case of the VAWT. And synchronizing with the grid is a highly challenging task in case of the VAWT because the power fluctuations are high. And it normally requires guy ropes. You can see that all the wind, the vertical axis wind turbine, the top will be connected using the guy ropes, and because of which, in order to support and in order to maintain its posture, it has to have the guy ropes on top. And because of this, this has limited in its applications, mainly in offshore states, it is not possible to install this VAWT. And another one main drawback is this VAWT will produce more noise. So it is not possible to install the VAWT in places where there is more human or more animals or whichever is living. It will cause full of noise pollution. So it should be a very remote location. Only then the noise will not be disturbing the population which is in and around. That is the main drawback in case of the VAWT, that is vertical axis wind turbine. And also there is another one drawback, that is, you all know that the wind speed will be increasing with respect to height. So you can see that horizontal axis wind turbine, it is placed with a very height when compared to vertical axis wind turbine, because the vertical axis wind turbine, there is a limitation, and it is similar to egg beater.
and it is nearly placed at the ground level, and because of which it will not be able to tap the wind energy that is the high potential wind energy which is present at the top. Okay, so you know that the wind speed is increasing as you go in height. Okay, that's why we place in order to extract more wind energy, we will be placing it on very height. But this vertical axis wind turbine, it is very difficult to have a very height structure. And because of which the power generation is also limited in this case. That is the tower height limits the power generation. And also another one thing is I just want to tell that VAWT are under only development stage, and the technical feasibility and other things are under studies only. Whereas HAWT, that is horizontal axis wind turbine, are well established technology and also well proven technology. But since it is having some maintenance issues, that is the only problem. That is the generator and gearbox are at the top in the nozzle, and because of which this maintenance is quite difficult when compared to VAWT, and that is only the drawback in case of HAWT. And because of, and also VAWT is one more advantage, is there is no need for yaw control. So these are all something which this research and other things are getting on to know. So now also, and there are various speed control strategies for the wind turbine. So the various speed control strategies for the wind turbine are initially they follow like what is the requirement of this speed control is mainly in order to implement the maximum power point. As I told, when you implement the maximum power point, you can extract 5 times the power which is present in the wind. Okay, for example, a single windmill can produce 5 times energy. Can produce 5 times energy if MPP is placed. Okay, if MPP is there. That's why. So in order to have the MPP, that is maximum power point tracking, you have to change the wind turbine speed according to the variations in the wind speed. So when the wind speed changes, the wind turbine speed also should change proportionately in order to maintain the TSR. That is the tip speed ratio constant, which is equivalent to the, which is corresponding to the CP max value. That is the main thing you want to have. So there are four different types. One is called as the no speed control at all. So earlier in 1990s, they followed this. That is, they are not bothered about the speed control. Since the power demand is also very less, they just placed it and they were using no speed control. And the MPPT was also, MPPT came into familiar only at 2005. And because of which the speed control were not that much attractive during those days before 2005 and all. But once this thing, that is the technology improvements and other things have happened, then they implemented this yaw control. What is the use of this yaw control is you can place the nozzle in the direction of wind to extract more power. So this is the yaw, as you all know that in case of yaw control, which is you can see that this yaw will be over here and that yaw will be moving this nozzle. And the blades will be placed such that it is facing the wind direction. That is called as yaw control. Okay. And then they slowly move to pitch control. That is the third type, as I said, is nothing but pitch control. So what do you mean by pitch control is, that is in case of blades, pitch control is nothing but the blade control. The blade angle can be adjusted by means of using the hydraulic technology. So what is the use of adjusting the blade directions? As you know that the blade angle should be between some 10 degree to 15 degree, that's all. So if it is going beyond that, then this blade will not rotate, and because of which it will come to the stop condition. And by adjusting this blade angle between 10 and 15 degree, you can see that the turbine speed also will be adjusted because the lift force is getting adjusted. Okay, by adjusting the blade angle, the lift force is getting adjusted, and because of which the turbine speed also will be adjusted, and by adjusting the turbine speed, the maximum power point can be tracked by varying the tip speed ratio, which is corresponding to the maximum power coefficient, that is CP value. So please understand. So then that is called as pitch control. And the last one is stall control. In case of stall control, the blade is shifted to a position such that it is stall when the speed exceeds the safe limit. Sometimes in case of stall control, what they will do is, that is the blade itself will be designed in such a manner such that when the wind speed is increasing, automatically the blade design will restrict the turbine speed to a low value. So So by implementing this, but the thing is only in low power applications this stall method is used, whereas in high power applications this pitch control mechanism is used, because pitch control mechanism is the most suitable form, most suitable method to extract more energy and to track MPP when compared to the stall control method.
Okay. So now moving on, we will discuss about the what are the wind speed characteristics. Okay, so wind speed characteristics. So in case of wind speed characteristics, you can see that there are four different regions. Okay, you can see that there are four different regions. So one is that is the low speed region. The next one is maximum power coefficient region. The third one is constant power region. And finally, we will end with that is the furling speed region. So you can see that in case of low speed region, that is it is the speed between 0 and cut speed, it is the speed between 0 and cutting speed. In this region, the turbine is kept in the braked position until the minimum wind speed about 5 meter per second, known as the cutting speed, becomes available. But below this speed, the operation of the turbine is not efficient. As I said, the losses will be very high. And the second region is maximum power coefficient region. In this region, the rotor speed is varied with respect to wind speed so as to operate it at the constant speed to speed ratio corresponding to the maximum power coefficient CP max. In this range, the nature of characteristics is close to that of the maximum power available in the wind. The turbine is operated at maximum power output point using the pitch control. And the third region is nothing but the constant power region. This is the third region, that is the constant power region. This is the first region, that is the low speed region. And the second region, we have completed maximum power region. And the third one is the constant power region. So during high wind speeds, about 12 meter per second, the rotor speed is limited to an upper permissible value based on the design limits of the system components. In this region, the power coefficient is lower than CP max. Large machines use pitch control to maintain the turbine speed as constant. Such a machine is known as pitch regulated. But whereas in case of classical European machines use fixed blades with constant speeds, and the blade twist and thickness are designed so as to crudely maintain the speed as constant, such a machine is known as a stall regulated. This is a simple system requiring only passive torque, as there are no moving blade surfaces or complicated hardware. However, power capture is somewhat less due to rounding of power curve in case of the stall regulation type. So now we will move on with a slight detailed study of power versus wind characteristics when we use, that is, a high twist for fast running as well as for low twist, that is how the stall regulation works. So in case of fixed blade rotor, the flow over the blade stalls. The stall performance depends on the twist of the blade tip from the root and thickness of the blade sections. The lift and drag coefficients change so as to flatten out the peak of the power curve. Thus, the power output of the wind turbine is limited. Whereas in case of stall regulation can be used without much problem up to about 25 meter diameter rotor. Above this size, the severe vibration problems associated with stall flow in high wind speeds have been encountered, and because of which large HAWTs will always be used with the variable pitch control. At still higher wind speeds, such as gust, constant speed orientation is maintained by employing additional means such as some kind of braking, example eddy current braking. And the last one is that is the last one in the discussion of this thing is furling speed region. So what do you mean by furling speed region? So beyond certain maximum value, that is above 25 meter per second of the wind speed, the rotor will be shut down and the power generation stopped in order to protect the blade from the mechanical vibration which the blade will not be able to withstand, and because of which the generator and other components of the system will be protected from the heavy winds, and because of which the damage of the wind turbine will be avoided. Okay, that's the end of the, we came to the end of this video, and I hope that this video will be useful to you, and if it does, please give this video a thumbs up, and if you want to see more videos like this in future, please hit the subscribe button, and in that way, and if you really want to see more videos like this in future, please hit the subscribe button, and in that way you will receive a notification at any time the videos like this are posted in our channel. And that's all I had it for today, and I hope to see you in the next video in future. Thank you very much. Bye.